Welcome back to Buckeye Bigfoot, and welcome to day 8 of Squatchmas. Now, I'm going to keep it pretty short tonight. I mean, Sundays are kind of quiet, aren't they? Well, they are here, anyway. So make sure you've got everything ready and you're all saddled up and ready to go, because we're moving on out and heading into Sasquatch Valley right now. Hi, Nance. I used to drive a school bus down in the southeast part of Kentucky, Letcher County. I had lots of rural pickups on my route, obviously. One of them made me go down a road that had been blasted out of rock, and that left high rock walls on both sides of the road. These kinds of roads are all over in Kentucky. But one time, it snowed a lot the night before. But school was open anyway the next day, because they got the roads all cleared up before then. So I'm going down the road where the rock walls are, and there's snow and ice on them, and the trees that cover them where it's a regular hill above them and not rock cut. It was all white up there. I can see straight on down the road. In all that white, though, I see a dark thing. Looks like a big falling rock just crashing down through all the snowy trees up there. Snow is getting shook off all the way to the very tops of the trees. I come to a stop as quick as I could, because I didn't want to get slammed with a big rock rolling across the road. I'm closer to the thing now, and I see that it's coming down more and more. It's not stopping. And I see that it ain't a rock. It looked to me like maybe a bear had been up a tree and fell out, and now it was sliding all the way down and couldn't stop itself. Looked like it was going to shoot right out across the road, because where they blasted the rock, it drops straight down. So the natural hill stopped sudden-like. Just think, if it had been rain instead of snow, it would be like that bear was on a big water slide, and the road between the two rock walls was the pool. And that's kind of what happened. The bear comes tumbling halfway down onto the road and half on to the snowy shoulder of the road. It lay there for about a second, second and a half, and I'm wondering if it's hurt or dead, and I get scared when I don't see it move. I pick up my radio, and I'm about to key the mic to have somebody come scrape that thing off the road when it starts moving. I'm thinking, oh, goodness, my Lord, it made it. Then, it looks like it's up on all fours, and I felt better thinking it's okay. I'm about 1.5, maybe 2 bus lengths away from it. Then, I got the shock of my life. That bear stands up, and it starts walking on just 2 feet. And that's when I knew that wasn't a bear. My jaw is in my lap. It looks right up to me sitting in the bus. We lock eyes for maybe half a second. Then it walks over to the rock wall that it had just rolled down from. It starts climbing back up the rock wall. It reaches the bottom of a young tree, pulls it up a little further, and bends the tree in half, pulling itself up that natural part of the hill above the rock cut. Once it got up there, it stood up, and it looked back at me again sitting in my bus. Then it started working its way back up the hill, grabbing onto the trees and pulling itself up through the snow the whole way. And I do think it was hurt, too. When it landed down on the one shoulder, and when I watched it climb, it was acting like it didn't want to use that arm unless it absolutely had to. That thing went right up that portion and up over the top of that hill in no time. It was easy to see because mostly everything up there was all white. I thought about it all day, and I've thought about it a lot of days since. I don't know what else it could be, except a Bigfoot. No human could have taken that fall and got up like that thing did. I also know it couldn't have been a bear to walk and do what it did. I know, too, that the rock wall face that was blasted in that area is about 11 feet at that point. I know, because me and my husband came back out and measured it. And that bent young tree was the marker for the right spot. And I'll have you know, That tree stayed bent. No human could do that, and neither could a bear. So, yes, there are Bigfoot in southeast Kentucky. Not many believe me when I tell them this, but that's their problem. One of these days, they're going to be out there, and they're going to run into one. And then we'll see whose problem that is. Thanks, Cora. Well, hello, Nance. I've started listening to your channel about a month ago, and I must say, your voice is by far the most soothing and calming. I love hearing the encounters while I rest my head. On my pillow, that is. Well, okay, so I have a couple of stories of somewhat encounters, but never have I got to see the big man yet. But anywho, here it goes. I am a Native American from Utah. My father was a Vietnam veteran. We lost him back in March. I once had a chance to ask him about anything that he came across that was out of the ordinary. He told me about an incident that happened to him and a friend while him and his friends were hanging out at a well-known party spot. They had their music blasting, and they were having a good old time. They had all their trucks parked side by side. They were out of their trucks just standing around. Now, when they ran out of their drinks, they were all asking one another, "Did anyone bring any more?" Well, that was it. My dad and his friend stopped talking and doing everything. Then my dad saw a man digging around in the bed of one of the trucks that was parked out a little further out than the rest of the trucks. And he asked his friends, "Hey, who is that and what's he looking for?" You got to remember, it's dark, and I had left out that they had a fire out there to stay warm. While looking at this person, who is still looking around in the truck bed, the owner of that truck was shocked and said, "I didn't bring anyone with me." Then that man stood straight up, and he was 2 feet taller than the cab of the Chevy. The Chevy had no lift. It was stock. Now, this party spot is only 3 to 4 miles east of the famous ranch. And I just want to interject here, folks, that Alex didn't specify. And the only ranch that I know of in Utah that is really famous is the Skinwalker Ranch, or as it is also known, the Sherman Ranch. Just thought I'd throw that in for y'all so you had a little perspective of where he was in Utah. Everyone got in a panic mode, and everyone jumped onto each other's trucks and hauled it to my dad's place. They had told other friends about it. While they were in the living room, my mother comes out of the back room. Now, the hallway is straight back, and from the kitchen, you can see down the hallway if you were to look. I hope that makes sense. But anyway, as she's coming out of the bedroom, walking towards the kitchen, she sees someone looking in the window, but she doesn't pay any attention to who it is. Then our next-door neighbor calls and tells my mom, "There's a tall man looking in your window." So she tells my dad. My dad gets quiet and tells his friends, "That thing followed us." So after saying that, they all get up and run outside. But when they get outside, there's nothing. At this time, the friends are pretty much shook up. They all decide to leave. So they all took off and went home. After hearing about that story, I got hooked. I told my dad that after hearing that story, dang, that's got to be shocking. I didn't know what to think of all of that. I do pass the area time to time, and I think to myself, dang, that whole story started right here, and that thing, whatever it was right here. Well, that was one story. I hope that story was a good one. My experience now, well, there's been a couple of good ones. Okay, here it goes. Hope this ain't too long. I was hunting for elk, and me and my girlfriend had located some elk. We seen a big bull elk. It was on the bottom of a big draw. Once they know they've been seen, they go up high where no roads are. So we hiked up the ridge to see if we could catch up to the big elk. We could hear the elk bugling and cows chirping. We got closer to the herd. While walking, I had noticed a big boulder rock on my right side. As we are walking up the ridge, I'm breathing hard. On the side of my vision, I see a furry-like thing, like it had rolled up the boulder, you know, instead of rolling down the boulder, like how gravity takes its toll on any object. So I stop. Then I tell my girlfriend, "Did you see that?" She replied back, "Holy crap, you saw that too?" And I said, "Heck yeah. What the heck was that?" It was the size of a basketball. We didn't know what to think. Then maybe 2 minutes had passed, and we stopped hearing the elk. All of a sudden, it gets way quiet. Then we hear it, yelling, way loud, like as if we got into its area or on its land, and it didn't like it. We were shocked. The yelling was coming from the top of the ridge, where it's way thick. The pines, you couldn't see in them, and the quakes were the same. I noticed that on the quakes. There was hair high up on the tree. I mean way high up, like 9 feet up, and I'm only 5'7", and I know it was and had to be that high up. So it's still yelling. I tell my girlfriend, "Do you have your phone?" She says, "Yes." So I tell her, "Record this yelling." So she did. And yes, we got the heck right out of there. I told her, "Go first, and I'll be behind you." She had her .45, and I had my .357. We was ready for it if it had decided to come terrorize us. We had made it back to the truck, which was maybe 800 yards from where we had all that happen. I told her, "We are going to let your dad listen to that." I was excited, but then not really, because we didn't get that bull elk. Oh, well. We told each other, "Let's get out of here." So we did. We hauled butt all the way back home. Home was 2 hours away. Man, that was a scary one. What I like to do, though, is go shedding. Shedding is when an elk or a deer's antler falls off the head, and then it goes into the process of growing new ones. Well, anyway, I went to this area where I'd seen elk and deer around the time frame when they start shedding. I went to this area excited, thinking and telling myself, "I'm going to find me some." So I started walking this ridge. All of a sudden, I get this ugly feeling that someone is watching me. So I stand there, looking around, but I don't see anything. I shake it off, and I continue to walk. Then I heard a loud whoosh, or like a shush sound. It was something doing that sound. It did it 4 times. The sound was so powerful, it felt like it went right through me. I stopped and I looked for where it was coming from. Then again, nothing. So I stay still to see if that sound would sound off again. And here comes a whoosh again. I started feeling sick. So I called my girlfriend and I told her, "There's something up here and I'm getting out of here." So I did. I went back to the same area again to see if I could find any tracks, and there they were. So I got my camera and made a little video on what I found. The track was blown over. Just one track I found, but it was big. So yeah, I don't know if it would be okay, but I do have it out on YouTube. So if you were to type in "that foot," you would be able to see what I got. Well, with that said, I think that wraps it up about the big man. My people call it a dew pudge. And folks, I don't know if I said it right, so I'm going to put it up on screen exactly like he typed it out in a phonetic way. Now, he says, you know a Ute word. It means monster. Well, hope your viewers like my stories. And all God bless. Take care through this pandemic. And thanks, Nance. Thanks for sharing my stories and getting it out there. And shout out to my team, Finding Burrs. Thanks, Alex. And for everyone's information, I did try to type in that foot, and I came up with all kinds of podiatry. Alex, if you're out there in the comments section, could you maybe post a link to the thing on YouTube you're talking about? I appreciate it. And thank you for submitting your story, and as well to Cora. I do appreciate it. And for the rest of you, don't forget, if you've had an encounter you'd like to share, send it on in to contact@BuckeyeBigfoot.com, and we can get it up here and share it with everyone. Without you guys, there is no Buckeye Bigfoot. All right, everyone, let's get on to tonight's gift giving. Let's see what we have here. Ooh, nice. It's a copy of the newly remastered The Legend of Boggy Creek. Now, this is the Blu-ray DVD combo, and everybody wants this original. So let's see who the lucky person is. Ta-da! DJS. Now, DJS, I sent you an email earlier today. Please send me your address, and I'll get it right out to you. All right, everyone. Well, that wraps up today's eighth day of Squatchmas. Now, this wasn't as long as some of the others this week, but hey, I'm trying to make it last for y'all, folks. Until we meet up again tomorrow night, always remember, absence of proof is not proof of absence. Thanks for listening, everyone. Psst, hey, some big hairy guy just told me to tell you that you need to hit the like and subscribe button, and you need to make sure that you hit that bell, and then choose Get All Notifications in the drop-down menu. And you better do what he says, 'cause I don't think he's the kind you want to make mad.